Hokitika's never been short of natural treasures.
The sun is just booming. It's like HD, man. You know, like the air feels, it's just got that, you know, authenticity about it.
Fortunes have been made here from gold to green and now hopefully on the small screen.
There's some deep, deep history here, especially around Panamu and gold. And I think that's probably captured their imagination within this film.
Here we go for rehearsal, stand by.
After months of studio filming, the story set in the Hokitika and Dunedin gold rush has come home to the West Coast.
It's amazing. I mean, really, one of the things that's so special about the Luminaries is it's a story about New Zealand's history.
I can fall back on that stuff because I know it comes from the place. It belongs to the people, and my character's loosely based off a tupuna from here.
The BBC-backed production of the award-winning book has already been a plus for New Zealand.
We've never got less than probably 160 people working, filming, shooting, building.
And it's expected to attract more visitors to Hokitika.
You know, that's just gold for the region and sorry for the pun, but it's absolutely great. And there's some beautiful, beautiful spots. And for those to be highlighted to the rest of the world, we couldn't ask for more.
Although the architecture might have changed, the places featured in the book are still here, like here on Revel Street. It means fans can still visit the soon-to-be famous locations. They're just a little bit more modern.
We're a tourism town, so having something like this to be able to piggyback off is going to be fantastic, but I think people are going to be quite surprised on what we've just seen, on just how amazing this is going to be and what it's going to do for the town.
The series airs on TVNZ next year.
I think it's going to blow some people's minds.
Sam Clark, One News.